Hello everyone, today I'm going to talk about karma, reincarnation and Saturn. So you reincarnate on this earth only if you have pending karma. You cannot escape the cycle of reincarnation until you have karma pending to be experienced. Most people have a superficial level of understanding of karma. What you sow is what you reap, what goes around comes around. These are some of the common definitions you hear about karma. Although these statements are correct, there is much more to it than you realize. If what you sow is what you reap is what it says, then every action of yours like breathing, eating, walking is causing you karma every single second. If this is true, is it ever possible for humans to free themselves from karma? Is it possible to achieve liberation? So let me introduce you to another layer of understanding karma. It's not your actions that matter, it's emotions attached to your actions that matter. Let me repeat it. It's not your actions that matter, it's emotions attached to your actions that matter. The more you are attached to people and things around you, the more you create emotional bond, and it is this emotional bond which creates pending karma, making you to reincarnate again on this earth. So let's understand this concept astrologically. So we have five elements: fire, air, earth, water and ether. So out of these five elements, it's water which signifies emotions. So what are the watery signs in Vedic astrology? It's Cancer, Scorpio and Pisces. These are the three signs that rules water. So let's see some of the significations associated with these signs. Cancer, the first watery sign, is the fourth sign of the zodiac, which signifies mother. Scorpio, it's the eighth sign of the natural zodiac, it signifies birth and death. And Pisces, it's the 12th sign of the zodiac, it signifies completion and liberation. So if you notice, themes related to birth, liberation, reincarnation, death is clearly connected to watery signs, which indicates that water or emotions is responsible for your birth on this earth. Now let's consider Saturn. So we have seen how zodiac signs explains birth and death, liberation. Now let's consider Saturn, which is the planet that rules karma in Vedic astrology. So Saturn rules karma, it gets exalted, which means strong, in the sign of Libra. So Libra is the seventh sign of natural zodiac, which signifies people you interact with. It's not only your partners or spouse, but every single person whom you interact with is signified by the seventh house. Now Libra, apart from signifying people whom you interact with, it is also ruled by Venus, which signifies pleasures and material things. So Saturn gets strongest in the sign which signify people you interact with and which signifies pleasures and material things. This clearly shows that the more you interact with others, the more you activate your seventh house, which in turn activates your karma, that is Saturn. It's clear? So now, having least amount of emotional attachment to people and things around you is a key to being least affected by karma. Let me repeat it again. Having least amount of emotional attachment to people and things around you is the key to being least affected by karma. This is what you understand by looking into Saturn and its exaltation point. But this is not exactly what Matrix and Elites want. There are many ways in which Elites try to manipulate you to keep away from the cycle of liberation. They want you to create new karmas every single day. So for example, Elites are making people addicted to social media. So what does social media do? It does nothing but connect you to people across the world and share their emotions of joy and sadness every day of your life. So that now you know how you can reduce your karma drastically by controlling your emotional attachment to people and things. There are few more habits that you can make that makes sure that you attract least amount of karma. So key to understanding this is uncovering the significations of Saturn. So what does this Saturn signify? First thing, Saturn rules black color. Ever wondered why black is the color of justice, why lawyers across the world wear black? It's because Saturn rules black and Saturn signifies karma and justice. So if you want to be least affected by karma, especially on those days when you're expecting some important news, you should avoid wearing black color. Because if you wear black color, you're most likely to attract the results of your karma rather than attracting the results for your efforts. Okay. And the other thing, Saturn rules Saturday. Okay. Each day of a week is ruled by a particular planet and Saturn rules Saturday. Saturn is strong on Saturdays. So it tends to give you karmic results on Saturdays. Any major events in your life that has happened on Saturday is a result of your past karmas that you could not have escaped. Some of the most deadliest natural disasters, including tsunami, some of the deadliest cyclones have all happened under the influence of Saturn. It can be on Saturdays, or it can be when Saturn is exalted, or it can be when Moon and Saturn is together. So only under heavy influence of Saturn, you would have these kind of deadliest natural disasters. So again, it's very important you avoid doing anything important on Saturdays, because on these days, you're bound to get results based on your past karma rather than the results for your efforts. But one thing you should know is that Saturn delays but never denies. Saturn is the slowest moving planet in Vedic astrology. It takes around 30 years to complete one revolution around the zodiac. Whereas Moon, which is the fastest moving planet, takes just 28 days to complete the revolution across the zodiac. This is to show that the planet which gives results for your karma is a very slow moving planet, which means whatever good deeds you do or whatever efforts you put in, whatever new karmas you create, the results for that you experience very late. Okay, so far what have you understood? One thing is that it's the emotions that matters. It's not your actions that matter. So the least amount of emotional attachment to people and things makes sure you don't attract more karma. Second thing, avoid doing important things on Saturdays. Avoid doing mistakes on Saturdays, because it's going to be 10x more the bad karma that you attract. And if there's anything important, don't schedule on Saturdays, because you're most likely to get results of your karma rather than results of your efforts. And finally, don't use black color too much, because the more you use black color, the more you attract karma. So these are some of the things that I wanted to share today. Of course, I didn't get into the advanced stuff because it's very sensitive information. Probably if you guys like this information, I would like to provide part 2 to this audio. So yeah, until then, have a nice day.